Hey kiddos, time for another episode of STFA TV, and today we're doing the Barrel of Monkeys zip bag in the 5x7 size. And the great thing about this is you can do this in any color you want. I'm gonna do five different colors for the demos and web examples. Today we're doing the 5x7, so I'm gonna do it in the banana yeller. Okay, so I always print my stitch sheet. What are you gonna need? Your stitch sheet, the pattern, duh. Yellow vinyl, yellow zipper, yellow 5/8 inch cross grain ribbon, 3 inches times two if you're doing a crossbody. If you're doing a wristlet, you only need the one. Couple of lobster claws or D-rings. Ollie fun for that half lining on the inside to keep the raw stitching from being tactile. And then this has a applique inset for the label. I'm gonna do the label on this one in blue because blue and yellow looks good together. So what is the first thing we do? Well, after we've printed our stitch sheet, I am going to go through here and remind myself what our bag prep stitch, pieces and what our design pieces. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, those two, 7 and 8, are applique. Yeah. And then that's lettering, and that's lettering. And then this is design. And then from 14 through 17 are also going to be bag pieces. So the colors that you need to pay attention to when you're doing it and you want to match it to your bag are going to be 7 through 13. Steps 1 through 6 and 14 through 17 can be thread as close as possible to your vinyl color. Once you've gotten that taken care of, you hoop up some medium weight cutaway stabilizer, you throw it in the machine, and you run color stop 1. And yes, this is a big honking hoop for a little 5x7 bag, but I have got all of my 5x7 hoops with other stuff in it. So, see you in a minute. Okie dokie pokies, we have got our die lines for our lobster claw assemblies or D-ring assemblies stitched out. This is for the side and this is for a double crossbody. And you are just going to fish your ribbon through, fold it over, even up the raw edges, center it on those die lines. Tape it down, and because we don't like metal jangly bits, we're gonna tape the lobster claw too, because it's fun that way. Then we're gonna do the same thing on the other one. Fish it through, fold it over, tape it down. There we go. Oops, I didn't cut. Oh well, I think that's good enough. Yeah, that's probably good enough. Now for this, run color stop 2 to tack those down, and 3 to give you die lines for your zipper placement and vinyl. We'll be back after color stops 2 and 3. Woohoo! And there we go. We've got our die line for a zipper. Now we are going to put the zipper head off to the left. And since this is a mammon jammin huge zipper, we're gonna trim some of that off of there. And we are going to line this up. This is going to be a little bit, this is 1 inch apart. Most zipper tape is 1 inch apart. This is a hidden zipper. And it is the only zipper I have that matches this exactly. So I'm going to, it doesn't cover the die lines like it should. So I'm having to play the, yeah, is that right game? Sorry guys. I'm just gonna try and make sure that it is nice and evenly distributed all the way across. I did not realize, if I'd known that, I would have picked a different color to do for the sample, for the video. But I already got this much done, so we're gonna go with it, okay? Now, you are going to throw that in the machine and run color stop. Yes, that's my new numbering system. We're gonna run 4, and we'll be back to cut our vinyl, which will be interesting considering, yeah. All right, we'll be back in just a minute with our vinyl, and I'll give you the measurements when you get back. Okay, we got our zipper tack down, so I'm gonna peel this up. And because I don't have like zipper teeth, I'm gonna have to line my my vinyl up by indent. Ooh, that's gonna be fun. You are gonna need two pieces of vinyl for the front. For the 5x7, it's 2x6 and 6x6. And you're going to buck those, if you have teeth, buck those right up against the teeth. Make sure that you're covering your entire vinyl die line, top, bottom, left, right. I'm gonna put a little piece of tape on both sides just to hold it in place. Go ahead and throw it in the machine and tack that down with color stop 6. And we will be back after 6. But you know what? I lied to you and I'm sorry. I said run color stop 5 and we will be back. I also meant to say run color stop 6 so that you have your die line for your applique, for the label on your barrel full of monkeys. So I went ahead and ran 5 to tack down my vinyl and 6 for my die line. And now this is wet look and it's really thin. And it's gonna make an awesome looking label, I just know it. We're gonna make sure that our entire die line for our applique is covered. And I am going to just lightly tape the four corners so that it doesn't buckle or slip slide or any of that good stuff. And I'm gonna throw it back in the machine and I'm gonna run color stop 7. And let's see. Color stop 7, and I will be back to show you how to applique trim that after 7. Ooh, there we go. Now we need to trim that up. Here, here, here. Come here. Here. So grab your handy dandy duck bill scissors, and we want to catch just our label vinyl, not our barrel vinyl. And you want to get as close to that zigzag as you possibly can. And swoop. And swoop. And there we go. Now we are going to run the next 5 colors. The next 5 colors, it's gonna do white and then orange lettering, purple lettering. Then you're gonna do, for this one, it's gonna be a medium yellow for the barrel and then a darker yellow for the barrel. All those are design elements, and we will come back to the pink step. See you at the pink step. Woohoo! And here we are. We've got all of the design elements done on our barrel. So now we are at color stop 13 or 14. I can't remember exactly. It's the pink stop. It is where we flip our hoop over and we lay some ollie fun. And you don't have to cover the whole back. You just need to cover about that much. But I'm gonna go ahead, since this is the piece that was already cut, lay it over, tape it down, throw it back in the machine, and then run the next color stop, and we'll be back to trim out in just a second. Okie dokie pokies, we've got our ollie fun tacked to the back so that it hides all of that nasty and raw embroidery on the inside of the bag. And we are going to trim the top carefully. Don't snip your stitches. And we're gonna trim a little bit on the left and the right, because here shortly we're gonna need to do our zipper trick. And we're getting ready for our zipper trick by opening our zipper. Come here, zipper. And you wanna open it about 2 fingers from the right. You also wanna put a little piece of tape for your transitions. And you want to tape your zipper head down. And this is an excellent time to remember, put a small tear so that later we can turn this. Put it back into the machine and run color stop. I believe it might be 14 or 15. I'll have to go look. And I'll be back right after that. Okay, there we go. Now it's time for our little zipper trick. And if you've never done an STFA bag before, I do this little snip tuck kind of thing to make the ends look a little bit more finished and professional. So what you have to do is take a pair of scissors and cut the teeth out of the ribbon. You want to leave the ribbon. You want to cut all the way to that tack line, but then you want to come back about 1/4 inch and cut the teeth. There you go. Then put your tape back down, lift up your ribbons, put a small slice right along the stitch line, and about 1 inch long, and tuck your ribbons to the back. And we're gonna do that on both sides. Make sure you're only tucking the ribbons to the back. Don't, like this one just decided it wanted to do, tuck the teeth. Arg. All right, so pull your ribbons through. Come over here. And again, pull back your tapes. Cut to the top and bottom of the teeth, all the way to the tack line. But then come back about 1/4 inch, and cut out the teeth. Put your tape back down, lift the whole mishugana up. Yeah, I got tape everywhere. And then slice and dice, ha ha ha. Come here, there you go. And fish the tapes, the zipper tape through, but leave the teeth on top. Push it down, flip it over, and we are going to crisscross applesauce and put a little piece of tape to hold it in place, just like so. Then we're gonna come over here and we're gonna do the same thing. Crisscross applesauce, find a piece of tape. I know I had tape around here somewhere. I have all the tape. Tape it down. Might wanna trim that little sticky outy thing. Put it back in the machine and run the next color stop, and then we'll be almost done. Yay! Almost done. Are you excited? I'm excited. Okay, so we got a little bit of stuff to do here. First and foremost, we're gonna pull up our tapes. Okay, definitely want to pull those up instead of stitching them into the bag. So there we go. We're gonna trim any of our little nasties and hairs sticking up and making my life ugly. There we go. We're gonna come over here and we're gonna pull up this tape. Now, we're about to put the back on, so we are going to have to fold our lobster claw assemblies down. So, we need to cut almost about 1/8 inch, maybe even 1/16 inch shy of that tack line that just sewed there, okay? And then we're gonna come across, see our little tabby tab, and we're gonna fold this down. So see, about 1/8 inch, maybe even 1/16. Fold it down, tape the hardware out of the way. Come over here, we're gonna do the same thing. Don't cut on that line, cut to that line. You're gonna stop about 1/8 inch shy. We're gonna fold our lobster claw assembly down. We're gonna tape it down. We're gonna get rid of that little hair right there. Blurg, yuck. We're gonna flip it over. We are going to cut our ribbon tails off now that they've been tacked securely in place and look decent and nice. We're going to make sure that we have a slice in our stabilizer, so when all said and done, we can turn this bad boy. Now we're gonna flip it over. Everything's ready to go. Let's find our back. There's our back. And we are going to line it up with the top. And I am going to put 4 pieces on the 4 corners just to hold it in place. And I am going to run color stop 17. I am not going to run color stop 18. 18 is a dead stop to keep the head of your machine from moving over the center of your work. You know how at the end it does that, ta-da, I'm done, and it moves the needle right to the center of the hoop? We don't want that because we've got metal here and it'll All right, so go ahead and run 17 and then we'll be back for trim and turn. Woohoo! And there we go. It is all done. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna flip this over and we are gonna grab a pair of scissors and we are gonna very carefully cut out the stabilizer behind the zipper. Please do not cut your zipper. Please do not cut your stitches. It would be awful to have made it this far and then slice open your zipper or your stitching and all that work was for bleh. So very carefully cut off the stabilizer. Yay. And now we are going to unhoop. There we go. And this is where I say grab your ruler and your rotocutter, except that this is a blur-shaped bag, so there are no straight lines. So this is an all scissors cut. You want to cut about 1/8 of an inch away from your stitch line. There are not any really big innies or outies here. So we're not going to have to do that whole clip your curves, blah, blah, blah. It should hold its shape just fine without darts and inserts and blah, blah, blah. Wow. If you're hearing background noise, the darling hubby is trying to fix my door. I got locked in here because the door wouldn't open. So he's messing around with that stuff. Okay, there we go. And yes, I did just throw that on the floor. We are going to reach our fingers in and we are going to pop off our tapes. There should be 3 pieces of tape. So 1 tapey wapey. Erg. 2, oh look, 2 and 3 are stuck to each other. So there we go. We are going to get rid of the tape because the tape's annoying. And we are going to slide our zipper all the way open. There we go. And we're gonna reach our hand down and we're going to turn. This is the fun part. Arrgh. Wrestling with vinyl. It's always how I like to end my day. Sometimes the vinyl wins. Aha, I won, yes. All right, and you're going to need something to pokey our corners because they don't always want to turn exactly how you want them. Erg. Okay, so something rounded but firm. And we're gonna poke out our corners. And we're gonna poke out, come here corner. There you go, poke out our corner. And we're gonna come down here. Oh. And my pokey-outy thing is not long enough. I need a longer pokey-outy thing. Okay. And yes, that is a crochet hook that I'm using to poke out. Come here. That corner just doesn't want to go out. It wants to stay in. That corner's a homebody. All right, there we go. Pokey out and pokey out. And now we're gonna roll our seams. And no, your vinyl is not going to stay rolled. Why? Because it has spent its entire life flat and now you're asking it to do a 180. So you can either get it rolled out like you like it and then stack some books on it, or my new super awesome trick is once you get everything rolled out how you like it, rolled out, you can take some clover clips and some felt, and then you can clover clip them and let it sit for 12, 24 hours or so, but you want to do it all the way around the bag. So I will clover clip without you in just a moment. But there you go, there's your Barrel of Monkeys zip bag. Peace.